If you have used ChatGPT, you have interacted with OpenAI's Chat API. Hi, my name's Hwani Bryson. Today we're going to build our own chatbot with the power of ChatGPT in Go. First, we'll take a quick look at how OpenAI's APIs work. Next, we'll use the Chat API in the terminal. And finally, we're going to build our own Jim Carrey chatbot in Go. So OpenAI's APIs are made of stateless HTTP requests. You basically send a request and then get a JSON response back. To use these APIs, you need to provide an authentication token. To get this, create a login at openai.com, and from here you can generate a token under your user profile. It's important to know that these APIs aren't free, but when you sign up, you will get some trial credit. So in the terminal, I'm going to export OpenAI key is equal to the AI key that we generated earlier. And now I'm going to use the chat API with curl https://api.openai.com/v1/chat/completions. And then we need to add some headers. So the first header is going to be content type application/json. And then the second header is going to be authorization, and the bearer token being our OpenAI key. And then we add our request body, which is going to be a JSON object. The first field is going to be the model, and I'm going to go with GPT 3.5/turbo. And then it takes an array of messages, and I'm just going to put one message in here with the role of user and the content, what should I have for lunch? Finally, I'm going to add another field for max tokens, and I'm going to set this at 1024 just so that there's enough tokens to always get a complete response. And I want to pipe it through to python.json.tool so that it gets formatted nicely on the command line. So we can call this, and it comes back with this message. At this point, the AI is responding kind of similarly to how ChatGPT would respond, but we can make this a lot more interesting if we add a different type of message to our messages. In messages here, we had the role user, but I'm going to add another type of message, which is going to have the role of system. And here we can preface the AI with some kind of contextual information about how we want it to behave. So I'm going to make it a lot more interesting by going content, integrate a dad joke into each response. And if we enter that, the response has a little bit more personality. Instead of saying, I'm an AI and I don't have an opinion, it says, why don't you have a corny dog for lunch? It's the perfectly cheesy option. So this isn't quite chat yet. The way that chat works is that we need to give it the previous history of messages as well each time that we call it. We'll bring this up one more time, and this time I'm going to add this message to our list of messages. So I'll just paste it here. And finally, I'll add one more message from the user. So I'm going to say role user, and then content, what drink goes well with that? And before I send this request, I'm just going to get rid of these apostrophes here, because otherwise they kind of mess with the string parsing. And now we get, you can wash down that corny dog with a nice cold punch of lemonade. Now we're having a chat with an AI that's paying attention to the history of our conversation. So now that we've seen how the chat API works, let's program our own chatbot, but in Go. So I'm going to jump into the terminal here and call go mod init to initialize the project. And then I'm going to go code main.go, give it the package name main, and create a main function. Next, I want to create an OpenAI new client. Now we need to pass in an API key, os.getenv to get our environment variable, and our environment variable is called OpenAI key. Now before we continue, I'm going to save this and then jump back into the terminal and call go mod tidy just to pull in the OpenAI package. And then I'm going to jump back into the main function, and we're going to set up our chat history. Request is equal to OpenAI, and I want a chat completion request. And in here we have to provide a model, so I'm going to look for the turbo model, and then we're going to provide some messages. And messages is going to be an array of OpenAI chat completion messages. And to start with, all I want to do is define how I want the model to behave. So I'm going to set the role. I want a system role. So chat message role system. And then we can provide the content, which determines how the chatbot's going to behave. And I'm going to say respond as an exaggerated Jim Carrey.
Alrighty then.
The last thing I'm going to set for my model is just the max tokens, and I'm going to set this to 124 so that it basically responds to most requests. Next, I want the chatbot to respond to user input, so I'm going to go with format.print and just provide this arrow here to indicate to the user that we'd like some text input. And I'm going to define a scanner with buff.io.newScanner, which uses the standard in as our reader. And next I'm going to say for s.scan, and then we're going to append to our request messages. And this message is going to have the role of the user since it's based on user input. We're going to say content is equal to s.text. And now that we've added the user message to our messages, we can ask for a response back. So I'm going to say response error is equal to our client dot create chat completion. And I don't really want to cancel this request, so I'm going to just use a background context and then pass in our request. If the error is not nil, then we will panic. Otherwise, we're going to print out the response. So we're going to go format.printf and pass in the string and a couple of new lines. And the string that we're going to pass in is going to be response choices, and we'll just get the first choice message.content. The next thing that we want to do is keep the chat going. To do this, we're going to go request messages. We want to append the response. So in here, we're going to go response choices and again grab the first one and then grab the message itself. The last thing we want to do is indicate to the user, okay, it's time to give us more input. So I'm going to go with format print and then just pass in that same string as before. So now our chatbot's complete and it's time to talk to AI Jim Carrey. So I'm going to call go run and I'm going to say, hello, what movie should I watch? And we get a very, very enthusiastic Jim Carrey-like response saying wowza and generally recommending his own movies, which is great. So then I'm going to continue the chat with, I want an action movie. What do you think? And see what AI Jim Carrey says to that. And now he's suggesting Die Hard or The Matrix. Of course, with his classic, alrighty then. The chat API is a great way to use AI-powered tools with contextual history. I'm really interested in seeing how people creatively use this tool going forward. I've been Hwani Bryson, happy chatting, and I'll see you later.